Welcome to the Vortimer's Watermill. This watermill was built in about 1860 and is a Poncelot Bress shop wheel. It is 4.5 meters in diameter and has 56 individual water buckets. This type of water wheel was invented by Jean-Victor Poncelot in 1823 while working at the École d'Application in Metz. This revolutionary new design roughly doubled the efficiency of existing undershot water wheels through a series of detailed improvements, and Poncelot wheels quickly became common in France and Germany. As far as we know, it is the only one of its kind in southern England, and one of the few still in existence in the world. The water wheel was used to drive a rack bench saw, much like the one you see today for cutting timber from the Poulton's estate into planks. The wooden teeth of the drive wheels are made from hornbeam, a deciduous broadleaf tree which you can see growing by the side of the mill. The mill has undergone two extensive restorations to return it to its original working condition. The most recent work was undertaken during the summer of 2014. This involved dredging and clearing the river from the mill to 500 meters downstream. Clearing the river needed extensive tree work, and if you stand by the water wheel today, you'll be able to see further downstream than has been possible for the last 100 years. All 56 of the custom-made buckets have been replaced on the water wheel, and the wheel itself repainted. Inside the mill, the drain in the pit below the large circular saw was unblocked and the rotting sawdust dug out and replaced. All the machinery inside is typical of what might have been seen in the mid-1800s. To your left, you can see a cart, which has markings on it, linking it back to a manufacturer in Leeds. In addition to the large circular saw, there are various smaller machines which were used for cutting and holding wood. On the walls of the mill, you can see varying sizes of cogs and circular saw blades, as well as large two-person hand saws right at the back. All of these items are original equipment that was used when the mill was in operation. We hope you enjoy visiting the fascinating piece of Poulton's history, and that the mill will be at Poulton's to be appreciated by many generations to come.